Beloved friends, I really inspire you to become a great leader. And who is a leader? Leader is a person who is leading a team of people to attain a definite purpose and goal in life. He trains in people, he inspires and motivates the people to work coherently with dedication and passion by giving them incentives and giving them better opportunity to be a good performer. And that leader is a great leader. But you know, the success of a leader is attaining the purpose and the vision and mission, and that is only possible when his total team or her total team is working in harmony, talking in unison, keeping the mind level-headed, committed, dedicated, passionately to get the benefits of a common purpose and goal. But there are different traits of a leader. The leader should never play blame game. He never blame for any failure to his disciples, to his people and his followers. The leader should have sympathy and respect for his fellows. The leader must have courage. He must have the mastery of task. He must have tried to understand all the implications the follower will face, and time to time he guide them and he really take care assessing the situation. The leader is bound to be successful. But one of the great quality of a leader is he has to be tactful. He has to be tactful and diplomatic. Most of the time the followers can do some mistakes, and the poor leader, the stupid leader, will criticize, will try to dampen the spirits, and the team will not attain the goal and the purpose and the objective, and mission and vision will be jeopardized. So what I emphasize here, be a tactical leader, a diplomatic leader, try to find out the reasons why the person is not doing well. You have to convince him about his mistakes. And once you really win his heart and convince him, then he will be a wonderful person and he will really achieve great success. I give you a story of great Andrew Carnegie. One of his employees was very good, but because of some circumstances, he became a drunkard and he starts coming late to the office and he did not perform well. It was a very sad news for Andrew Carnegie. One day he invited that person to his office and suggested him to come to his home for a dinner. And while the dinner was over, they went to the library, and then Andrew Carnegie asked one question to him. He told, now let's change the role. You become the chairman and I become the subordinate or the employee of the company. Then how you will deal with me once I am not doing my duty well? I'm mostly drunk and I'm not achieving the targets. The person was very afraid. He told, I know, Chief, you are going to fire me. Andrew Carnegie instantly suggested, if he was to fire him, there was no reason for him to invite for a dinner. And he explained his motive behind it. He wanted him to realize his mistake, and the man really realized it. And by self-realization, he transformed himself into a wonderful employee, coming in time, stopped all his bad habits, and he became himself a billionaire in due course of time. Now, lessons for the millions of the leaders who do not know, who are really not a great leader, because leaders are very few I have seen in my life. Mostly they are crooks. They are just getting opportunity because of their posts and positions, but they lack the true virtue of a great leader. A leader is nothing unless he wins the heart of his followers and he trained his followers very well so that the followers can really achieve all the vision, all the goals, all the targets set by the leader. Beloved friends, be a wise leader. Never play a blame game. Take the full responsibility of any failure and motivate your team. Try to give them well training, educate them, motivate them, inspire them, Similar is the case with the parents. The parents, be wise. Don't demoralize your children by criticizing them. You are hurting them and you are creating more enemies than you are finding a friend in your children or in your followers. Win their heart. Let them realize their mistakes, and whence their mind become filled with positive mental attitude, they can really attain any altitude in life. Self-realization, creating an environment and circumstances where the person knows that he is not doing good. And once a person is awakened, he becomes a mighty person. All men are born great. The kingdom of God is in every man. All can love themselves, love their vision, mission and purpose of life, and they can be a wonderful person. Last word, the bottom line. Let the person realize, let the person transform himself with a will to become a better person. Don't impose your power of postpositions or paternity, friends. Yours is the earth and everything that's in it, and you will be a great leader, my friend. Leader has to be respected. Leader has to be honored. Leader has to be worshipped like a godfather. The nation grows because of leader. A family becomes greater by a leader. Leaders, they are the savior of the world. Develop the traits of leadership. Win the hearts of your subordinates. Guide them, motivate them, train them, inspire them. Let them realize self, and then they are better than you. Tomorrow they will be a better leader. You have to create a lineage for the future growth and prosperity of any unit. I love you and I thank you for watching this video. But, realization. Thank you.